Coin and Stamp.
Hey everybody, it's Jordan here from West Edmonton Coin and Stamp. Today I'm going to show you guys how to protect and store your coin collection using various pages and albums. So the first and the most basic way is to use these pages here. They come in large, medium, and small. 30 pockets per page for large coins, 63 pockets per page for medium coins, and 88 pockets per page for small coins. And these just have a little protective flap so that you can store your coin in there and they'll stay within the page. Then once you get the coins into the pages, you just put them into any standard three-ring binder, or you can use a deluxe binder like these here. I would recommend using a deluxe binder with D-rings and a slip cover, and these are a heavier build of binders so they can store a larger load or heavier load. So that's the first and the most basic way. The next way is still using different pages for albums. You use these pages. These pages have 2x2 slots, 20 of them per page. So how you do that is you put the coin into these cardboard 2x2s first, which come in all different sizes. You put the coin there, you fold it over, and you staple it, and then you slide it in to the page. This is definitely a more versatile way of storing your coins. It offers a lot more protection using the cardboard 2x2s, and also you can write information about the coin on the cardboard 2x2, such as country, date, denomination, grade if you want, stuff like that. We sell these cardboard 2x2s in bundles of 20 here, or bricks of 100. If you don't want to use the pages for the cardboard 2x2s, you can also use double or single row boxes. So there's a double row box. Alright, so that's the pages and the 2x2s. You can also buy denomination specific albums. So there's a bunch of different ones. The most basic is the Blue Book. This will do Canadian pennies. It's got your page layout in the front. So where you're going to put each year within the page, and they use the same thing as those pocket pages. They got a little protective flap to keep the coin inside. Up from there we have the Lighthouse Cascade albums. These do not have the date specified in the inside. They use a higher quality page that pulls out. You put the coin in and then you push the page or the strip back into the page. So this system here is really good because, I mean, your coins aren't gonna go flying out of there at all. You can shake the binder and none of your coins are gonna come out. So we have these in all different denominations as well. They're nice and colorful. More denomination specific ones, we have these ones here. These are the, I just call them the brown books, but these are really nice. They have all the dates labeled underneath each pocket. This one in particular is Canadian dollars from 1935 to 1986, so all your Canadian silver dollars. They use a secure page as well that pulls out. You put the coin in there, you push it back in. We have these for all different denominations. We also have them blank, so there'll be no date ranges in the inside as well. And we also have refill pages for these albums as well. There's also these three albums over here. We have ones with leather slip covers, then we have ones with cardboard slip covers, and then we have ones with no slip covers. This is a really good starter album for collecting coins for sure. Comes with a whole bunch of different pages to accommodate. Oh, this one's actually missing pages. So this one's got all the pages, a whole bunch of different pages to accommodate all different sizes of coins, and they use that secure system so that it stores the coins safely within the page. We also have these ones here. This is the Lighthouse Vista albums as well. It's another one that's denomination specific with a certain date range. These use a different sort of cardboard page that has two plastic inserts. One pulls out, and then you pop the coin in there, and you put it back in. And it sort of secures the coin within the page. What I really like about these, this style, the denomination specific with the date ranges, is it has all the dates along with all the different varieties that's available in those coins. So probably the most premium product for denomination specific is this one here. This is the Lighthouse Vista albums. A really heavy duty binder, really nice, pulls out, it's got the, pulls out of the slip cover, it's got the coat of arms embossed on the front, uses the same style of system here with the cardboard pages, strip pulls out, you put the coin in, you push that strip back in. And once again, it has all the different dates. This is actually quarters volume two, and this will have all the different varieties of quarters within. So 1999 Caribou, January, February, all the Millennium quarters, all the special edition quarters for the Olympics, everything would be hosted inside this binder. So this is a really good system if you're trying to collect all the varieties and dates of a specific denomination, and we have them in all the Canadian denominations. So that's all the different albums and pages that we offer here at West Edmonton Coin and Stamp, all of which are available in our store here in West Edmonton Mall or on our website under the Coin and Stamp Supplies area on our website. Let me know if you guys have any questions by commenting below. I only covered a small portion of it here today. Like, I didn't even go over the paper money now that I think about it, but we also have the three pocket pages for paper money that come in singles or packs of 10. And we also have the little cute currency albums here too that can hold 20 pieces of paper money right off the bat. So let me know if you have any questions by commenting below. If you guys like that video, give it a big thumbs up there. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more coin-related and collectible-related videos. Thanks for watching, guys. Have yourselves a great day. I'm just gonna mess up the first take.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. Hey, everybody, it's Jordan here from